Hey YouTube, you really want to know how to use that? Same thing than using that actually.
It is estimated that about 500,000 photos are taken per second worldwide. Facebook shares more than 6 billion photos per month. Photography has never been so accessible and easy. You point, you shoot.
And yet, that kind of thing still exists? Not on my watch. Photography is not so complicated. My name is Nico, I'm a photographer and filmmaker, and in this series of videos dedicated to learning the photography basics, I will teach you how to go from zero to hero. And in this first lesson, we will start with an essential basic principle, understanding how any camera works.
Technology has evolved incredibly since the invention of photography, but basically the principle remains exactly the same between your camera and those of the 19th century. All cameras, even though in smartphones, use the same basic elements. First, a lightproof box that isolates the photosensitive material from the light so you can decide by yourself how much it will receive. For that, you need a lens, an object that refracts and focuses the light on the sensitive surface that rests in the dark room. Then all the cameras have an iris placed in front of the lens called aperture, and with you can modify, on most cameras, the size of the opening to choose the quantity of light you let enter. Finally, you have the shutter, a curtain that you open longer or shorter to choose the duration of exposure to light.
All cameras, since the invention of photography, work with these elements on the same principle, to define the amount of light with which a sensitive surface will be exposed.
Only thing that has really changed in 150 years is the material used as a sensitive surface. We have gone from chemical surfaces to digital sensors. It is this transition from film to digital that is the greatest revolution in photography since its invention.
So in the end, what's the difference between these two things? There are two main ones. The first is the method used to preview the image you want to capture. The sensitive surface is in the dark room, and in front of it, it's placed the shutter, the iris. So how do you see the picture you want to take?
The first method, the DSLR. Inside the body, the light is reflected on a mirror, then on a pentaprism to the viewfinder. The advantage of DSLR is the quality that can be achieved through the ability to change lenses.
The drawback is their size and their weight, as they must be large enough to hold the entire mirror system. And because of the mirror, the lens is far from the sensor, so it has to be big too to project enough light.
Another method that also allows camera with interchangeable lenses is the mirrorless method. Well, simply they have no mirror or prism, so the camera can be much smaller and lighter as well as the lenses. How does it work? The viewfinder is a digital viewfinder, it's a screen. The image received by the sensor is transmitted in real time digitally to the viewfinder.
Your smartphone uses this method, but also DSLRs when you switch to live view mode. The second and most important difference between all camera types is the size of the sensitive surface, the sensor.
The standard size is called full frame, which corresponds to the size of all 35mm films, so 24 by 36mm. There are larger ones, such as medium format, but more generally smaller ones, APS-H and APS-C formats, or the micro four third, or even smaller formats used by point-and-shoot cameras or smartphones. The size of the sensor is extremely important, since the larger the size, the more light the sensor will receive, and therefore be more efficient in low light. It will also affect the depth of field. The larger the sensor is, and the more we will have the possibility of having a shallow depth of field. It's the quantity and quality or the depth blur of an image, which allows to detach a subject from a background.
It's still a vague notion for you, but don't worry, we will come back to it in depth in a future video. In return, the larger the sensor, the larger the camera must be, and the more expensive it is. The size of the sensor will also influence the field of view generated by the lens. But again, this is a concept that will be discussed in a video entirely dedicated to lenses. Today, it was just a first introduction to understand how a camera works as a whole. The next video will be the most important because I will tell you everything about the holy exposure triangle, which is the heart of everything you need to know if you want to learn photography. So don't hesitate to subscribe to the channel, it's brand new, but especially to click on the little bell to know when the next videos will arrive. And if it pleases you, don't hesitate to send me some love by liking or in the comments. See you mate, keep on creating.